టీచర్స్ అనుసరణ అనుచరణ పర్యావరణ అనుసరణ బికాస్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్. So that is the word, that is the meaning of it when I say adaptation. You should remember that. Alright? Okay. See here, adaptation. It should lead always to the conservation. What to conservation?
Father, make this kundi.
Conserve and day. Saving. Saving. Saving everything. Preserving. So what to preserve? See here. Preserve wetlands, to save old buildings, to reduce the energy consumption. What is life? Very basic. If I ask you what is life, you ask your parents to define it. When you go home today evening, home, dad, mom, can you define life? They are all there, they don't know. Ask them to define. Give you the definition of life. That is the basic thing you need to ask. That is the right information. First you define your life. But you don't know how to define you. That is wrong. So life is defined by consumption, reproduction. First two, they don't need any explanation. Indians are doing wonderfully well. Consuming, reproducing, only the last one is the problem. That is zero. Absolutely zero. Nobody taught us. Our parents didn't teach us. Grandparents didn't teach us, our leaders didn't teach us, our teachers didn't teach us, our educational system has not taught us. That is a shame, shame, shame on Indian education. Now, only adaptation we have to be concerned. Without adaptation, you are not going to exist, you are not going to live at all. Only there are two options when you face problems. Obstacles in life, there are many, many obstacles in life in Nandyal itself. In India, thousands of obstacles for normal life. Actually, they are known as technically limiting factors. What are they?
Limiting factors.
That is the technical word. That means no food, no water, waste, and too many people, and the extinction of species, issue of water. Drought, famine, hunger, disease, poverty, all these are the limiting factors for human life, for all other life too. So, but we are referring only to humans now. So, there are thousands of limiting factors we are facing in Nandyal, and Andhra, in India, around the world. So, when there are limiting factors, only two things you can have. One is die, disappear, perish, or adapt. Those who adapt will live. Those who refuse to adapt, they will disappear. So now I'm going to show you a demonstration so that you will remember it very well. Boys are here? No boys? Okay, two girls will come here. These are two crows. Oh yeah. These are the two crows living in this ecosystem. Yesterday, I showed you, know ecosystem? Ecosystem is composed of three components. What are they?
Producers.
Okay, here in this ecosystem, these crows, father and mother, they are living 50 years. great-grandparents lived here, their great-grandparents, their parents, and this is the generation. Now you come here. Now they have hatched two eggs, and there are two chicks. There are two crows, the boy and the girl crow, baby chicks. So now, suddenly, 50 years paradise, no rain, no water, global warming, climate change, issue of water, all those critical factors what we are facing right now. This crows face, they are not stupid enough to stay in that ecosystem, like humans. We are the most stupidest species ever to appear on Mother Earth. In other words, only failure project is humans on this planet Earth. We goofed up everywhere and we crashed out this planet Earth and we are destroying our own future generations. You must have watched that video, that girl from Sweden, Greta. You know that, no? The International United Nations Action Convention in New York. You know that? He told you fools, you fools, you have destroyed our future. There are so many limiting factors, you are not talking about them. You are talking about worldly production, consumption, markets, high economic growth, cell phones, how to progress, how to build buildings, how to put 4 lanes, 8 lane roads. Shame on you. Shame on you. What we want is only good soil, good water, good air. That's all we want. We don't want technology. We don't want your cars, airplanes. We don't want your high-rise buildings, roads. We want only three. Is it too much to ask? Soil, water, air. That's what we are asking and you are asking. But your parents, your grandparents, your leaders, they don't want to give you that. They want to destroy soil, water, air. Your future heritage, your future investment is that. That is yours. You have got the right to fight and kick out all those progress and all those factories. Allow us to have a clean soil, clean air. Is it too much to ask? Is it too much to ask? Simple. Government can really help us to reach our target. Simple. We don't need money. If I keep you in one table, then I give GDP, money, I give gold, silver, technology, all those cell phones, everything on the table. I keep only dirty soil, little bit, and water, and little bit of air. Which table you would choose? Are you clear?
Yes, Father.
Are you confident?
Yes, Father.
Are you sure?
Yes, Father.
Yeah, that is the wisdom. Reject that table. You don't want that. Can you grow food in gold?
No, Father.
Can you grow food in soil?
Yes, Father.
Soil is brown gold. It is better than gold. In soil, it's a living community, not a microscopic bacteria. We are all one community. So today you need to defend soil, water, air. Reject everything, but go after soil. That's what these crows are going to do. They, no water, no food. They don't go to Chennai and import food. They don't go to Delhi and import water. They don't go to America and bring back some bread crumbs. No. They simply leave the environment. World is big, beautiful, lot of resources. Now they are going to, they are thinking about this generation. Look at the faces. They look at the future generation, these faces, and feel helpless. I have to do something for that generation. That is the responsibility of the parents, leaders, whoever. So now what they do, they don't want that environment. They want to ditch out and they have to go now in search of a fresh ecosystem where there is food, water, air. Now this cross might take, it might involve maybe hundreds of miles. They have to take the babies up to fly around and look around. They have a very good ecosystem which can support them for the next 50 years at least. So now they are leaving this environment, very sad. So they are leaving. So why don't you come here, father, mother? Now you spread out your wings.
You also. Stand here. You stand here.
Now you go to the last altar and you go and stand there and then you're going to tell, yes, that is the place where there is plenty of food and water. And you stand and look at me from there. Alright? Okay. While you go, you say, also not only producing babies buy some cars, put up some GDP, everything is included. You need to reduce. That is how you are going to adapt. So there are thousands of limiting factors. Teachers can take your students today after this lesson, maybe this afternoon, ask the children to identify the problems we face. They are not limiting factors. In Nandyal, where you live, in your street, in your neighborhood, and in Andhra Pradesh, and then in India, you identify. These are the examples. No food, no water, And I found for the past 2-3 days I have been going out very bad. Nandya, just outside the school you can't go without closing your nose. Such a filth is flowing. I mean, that is the disgrace for the water. Water is sacred. Sacred. Look at the water, what we have turned into. Such an open sewage. Can you imagine? People living in this part of the world, and every student for the past year, IPS, IAS officers, teachers, what did they do? What did they do? Still they are increasing only sewage. Smell is going higher and waste. The Nandya, when you go outside, it looks like a ghost town. It's a ghost town. Ghost town means nobody is in charge. Ghost town. Actually, you should name Nandya ghost town. But what those Nandis, 9 Nandis are doing? That God should help us. Those 9 Nandis should come and clean it up, and they will tell. Those Nandis will tell you, please act in our name. So, 9 Nandis sacred town. So look at the filth, what you have in Nandya. We should be proud about our culture. At the same time, we should create a clean environment. Without doing that, philosophy is waste, gods are waste. So you need to follow gods in their good teaching and employ and practice. Practical application is very important. You understand me? First thing, you keep your house clean. That is the first point. You keep yourself clean, your neighborhood clean, your house, your street. That is called Mahatma Gandhi Swadeshi principle. That means neighborliness. Keep your neighborhood clean and also safe. All those trees, animals, soil, water, that's the Swadeshi principle. Apna resource ka khayal rakhna. That is the Swadeshi. We Indian, by Indian, that's all explanation. But your tree, your neighbor, living on the left, right, front, back, above, and down. Kaya Brahma. Don't worry about others. You worry about your own immediate. And that is a Swadeshi. It may be human, or it may be soil, or it may be a tree, or it may be a pond. You understand me? Need not be human. Your neighbor can be anything. Under Buddhas or animals and plants or humans. That is your neighbor. See how lofty Mahatma Gandhian principles are. They are beautiful, beautiful. Anyway, United Nations is telling us adaptation is good. It is a new opportunity for us to become rich. We can reach to the top. Our species can become more mature. We can get PhD. Or we can see the golden age of humanity. So that is what United Nations is trying. Adaptation will bring immediate benefit and reduce the impact of climate change. Now India is known as the South Asia. That is the technical word. South Asia means India, Sri Lanka, Bhutan, Nepal, Pakistan. So these are the South Asia countries. So India belongs to South Asia. Adaptation is fundamental. Asia.
Actually,
what are they telling? We are experts. Indians are experts in adaptation. We have Mohenjo-daro and the Harappa, the Indus Valley civilization. Did you know that history? Harappa, Mohenjo-daro? No?
Maybe that portion in Tamil Nadu state only they will learn, not this Andhra.
Such a beautiful lesson. Teachers, why don't you part of this adaptation, talk to the children about Indus Valley civilization? That's a good lesson. How our ancestors, half of the children are from Indus Valley civilization genes. We have the Indus Valley civilization genes. Our ancestors escaped from the climate change. Those genes are passed, they are in your bodies. They are the remaining people of Mohenjo-daro and Harappa. Because our ancestors were smart, they were able to survive and pass the genes to this generation. They are surviving today. So we are experts. So this is a document you should download today when I go home. IPCC. You hit it and then you get the document in PDF file, you download it into your computer, and that document talks how to adapt, what kind of problems we are facing, everything. This is a picture which shows this is a 3 million years humans were evolving on this planet from here to here. See, it comes all the way here to here. All the species, they faced the limiting factors, isn't it? And all these generations faced limiting factors. No food, no water. Similar. But they were able to adapt. Here we are. They are the last. If our ancestors did not adapt, there is no humanity. You have to survive. So from here to here, the only one technique is adaptation. He became this. Then he became this adaptation. Linking is adaptation. Adaptation, here we are. Now, we need to adapt. Otherwise, we are going to end the humanity. We are going to let humanity go down. Look at, we started here. Four legs. Walking on four. Then walking on two. And walking straight up. Now, this one. Another man out of Africa. Look at the color is different. And here comes white man. And here comes the modern man. Look at the stomach. Again, very soon we are going to fall down and walk on four legs. Because too much weight in the front. So it's dragging us. So this is where we are. Humans started in four. They are going to end up in four, I guess. So there are a lot of limiting factors. The adaptation can be divided into two. One is the physical adaptation. Okay, what is the physical adaptation? Physical adaptation. Right, here is the physical adaptation. One example. These are called Darwinian finches. What are they? Finches, a bird. It's the same bird, but look at the beaks are different. Look at that. Darwin, while he was in Galapagos Island, he observed, don't talk. He questioned why same bird has different kind of beaks. That is the question. He wrote in a famous book called The Origin of Species. He wrote in 1856, famous book, you should read that book. So this is what he found. This bird lives in a very, very mountain area. So he takes food from the rocks, so very tough. See, this fellow is in the tree. He has to look food in the crevices, in the holes. So he has a sharp beak. So all these beaks are adaptation. They evolved in the process of adaptation in the environment in which they live. Alright? If this bird comes to the tree, he can't forage through, he will die. If he goes here to the rock, he can't survive. So every environment has the physical talents and physical body parts. Why do we have hands? Why do we have nails? Why do we have two legs and we are walking straight? Two. And why do the polar bear has a lot of fur? Because cold climate. So why do Himalayan bear is having black fur to protect from the cold? So that is called physical adaptations. Now, what is our physical adaptation? The limiting factor one is, you should remember, we are the victims of two revolutions. What are the revolutions? Tell me. In 1850, what revolution started off destroying our planet? Tell me. What is that? Industrial revolution in England. That destroyed the planet. And then came in 1960s, Green Revolution. That destroyed completely. So these are the two revolutions which destroyed our planet and your foundation for life, soil, water, and air, everything more. But now, you have to adapt. You have to clean it up. You have to reject. So you need to reject consumption. Don't simply be fooled by television. Fair and lovely, you won't buy fair and lovely, but still you are black only. So why do you want to buy all cheap business? Nothing does. These cell phones, they go on advertising. 1992 cell phone is also, we are talking here only. 2019 phone also, we are talking here only. We are not talking somewhere here. So everything is cheating business. You have to say no, no, no. Completely they are spoiling your mind. All advertisements are lies. They are not true as they promise. All lies. Money making business, profit making business. So what you need is today, concretely I want to tell you something. Are you ready? So the green, first of all, industrial revolution, you reduce buying stuff. Alright, all you should go for small carbon footprint, small houses, small family, small consumption. Everything is small, small, small base, small families, children, one or no like that. So small, small, everything is small. Not big budget at all, everything is small. And now, you know, agricultural revolution, you should do physical adaptation because we poison the whole earth. Now what you should do, in order to reverse, you need to cultivate your own food. Don't buy all the genetically modified food in the market. You are putting poison in your body. So the first thing, you go home today, find out traditional seeds, go to the village and buy traditional tomatoes, brinjal, bindi, papaya, moringa, all of them, bring them and put them in your garden and you grow your own garden. Produce your own vegetables. That is the first physical adaptation because you are putting poison in your body. By producing your own organic vegetables, don't put fertilizer, go for cow dung, goat dung, and also sheep dung. You bring them and make a mulch, beautiful, healthy food. You can eat the best of future generations you can produce. Your children will be healthy. They will be thankful that you adopted in time. Actually, time is running out. So we need to save the soil, save the water, save the air from those agricultural evil practices. Remember that? So now that is one issue. Thanks for asking. All right? The second one is behavioral adaptation. What is the behavioral adaptation? The things always do is okay. Behavioral adaptation means look at the way we are living around. See the way this is a mother, this is the baby. They give birth in shallow waters and then they go back to deep waters because babies will die if the mother gives birth in the cold waters in Arctic seas, very deep. But they come to Mexico and they give birth and then they swim back again 4,000 kilometers. Baby also swims and they go for the feeding ground for food. So that is behavior. They are pulled down. Also, you know how birds, well, you must see the birds coming from the north to south. That is a migration. There is a behavior. There is no food, very cold. Now they are flying here. And when the winter time is over, when summer comes there, these birds are again going back. You understand that? So now, what is your behavior adaptation? I want to teach you and finish the class. Now, you go deep inside it. You have been looking outside for resources, for money, happiness, for wealth. You are plundering the earth and destroying Mother Nature for your own happiness. But happiness is not outside. That is a misunderstanding. Where is happiness? Inside. That is where you find all the resources. GDP is inside, gold is inside, money is inside, economic growth is inside, technology is inside, everything is inside you. So what I'm telling, outside there are no resources, they are illusion. Inside your resources are great. What kind of resources? You have your love, empathy, compassion, kindness, tenderness, justice, righteousness, responsibility, faithfulness, accountability. All those resources you have within you and say enough. Satisfaction, enough inside you. So now if you open your inside resources and you take and give to so far you have been taking, taking, not giving back. All of you have Akshaya Patra. Do you know what is Akshaya Patra? You take it, it will not be going empty at all. It's going to spring out more and more. Akshaya Patra. You have Akshaya Patra. And you take resources, love and compassion and empathy, give to planters. And give to soil, give to water, and give to air, and give to the future generations. So, only one thing I want to tell you. Don't believe television. Television is telling us, media, only three things are going to save us. Politics. You think politics will save us? The second thing is high economic growth. You think high economic growth is going to save us? It's going to destroy further. You think? The third thing they are telling, science and technology will save us. Do you think science and technology is going to save us? It's going to cause more misery, more evil on us. Only one thing can save us. That is our inner resources. Those outside three things will not save us. But our inner resources of love, empathy, compassion, what you have deep within you, when you take it and give to Mother Earth, to the neighborhood, to everybody, this planet will come back again alive and we will find our future. I think that is the lesson what I hope to give you. So adaptation, you go home. Today you Google what is adaptation. Don't type adaptation, then it will take you to human adaptation. You should type ecological adaptation or IPCC adaptation. Alright, thank you so much. God bless. And this is the last information. You can write my name. You can download my books absolutely free of charge. On the internet, my name is Rayappa. Just Google Rayappa. That is my website. Planets Chaser. See the S in the middle. Don't miss it. PlanetsChaser.com. 1450 books are there. You can download the PDF file in your computer. All ecology and environment. My phone number is that. Email is that. And go to Google or what is that? YouTube. Just type my name, Rayappa Kasi. You ask adaptation. Rayappa Kasi adaptation. You just type. Another word. I got a lot of talks. You can type Swadeshi, Swaraj, Sambodaya, everything. You can listen to the talks in English and Tamil. I have not given any talk in Telugu, but you can listen. Thank you so much for this school. Mother, Rani, sister invited me. And our sister.
Elsie, Elsie.
Sister. Sister Annie,
Jackie,
Sister Jackie,
Shanta,
Shanta, all the teachers and all the students, I think people like you can change the world. Above all, change us, this old people mentality, no good. You should change your father and mother, your great grandparents, that previous generation, you should change them, convert them. But you have to show the way. But you have to show the way. Without the showing a way, you can't reject us. But you come up with a new plan, which is based on sustainability for the everybody. All right? Okay.
So, when we came inside, is there so many monkeys outside, no? That is one of you. So, children's stories. These monkeys, they're just going around itself. So, Rosemary chair was very nice handbag. So, the small monkey came and took her handbag. She went sat on the tree. She opened the handbag. Inside, she found one small mirror. She saw her face and she started crying, weeping. So mommy monkey no, came and asked, "What happened, my child? You are crying." "Mommy, mommy, I look so ugly. See, those people are so beautiful." Mommy monkey told itself, "Don't worry, you are more beautiful than those monkeys here. So those monkeys are beautiful than you all. You all came from them only, no?" So today being a soil day, fathers explained to you the importance of soil. So it's a coincidence. The soil day and father preaching for you also telling the importance of soil. So father, we surely remember you and pray for you. You don't believe in prayer, but still we pray for you. We pray for you and we promise you that whatever you thought for our children, at least one little bit you will follow, no? Keeping your house clean, and then planting some small plants in your house. You promise, Father, we will do, Father.
We will do, Father.
Raise your hands. We will do, Father.
We will do, Father.
We join our hands with you.
We join our hands with you.
So, Father, this is our promise for you.
Good afternoon, teacher.
Sir, with your permission, I would like to in the table, sister. In church of faith,
proceed.
Father, Yalu, Maradu, Chana Chakta Ga Vivari Chalu, Good Chain Nunchi,
state.
ఉత్పత్తిదారులు వినియోగదారులు విచ్ఛిన్నకారులు వాటికి మధ్య శక్తి ప్రసారం ఎలా జరుగుతుందో మనకు చాలా చక్కగా వివరించారు. అదేవిధంగా డార్విన్ పరిణామ సిద్ధాంతాన్ని తీసుకుని గ్యాలాపాగోస్ జీవులలో పిన్స్ పక్షుల గురించి చేసిన పరిశోధన గురించి వివరించారు. తర్వాత పక్షుల యొక్క వలస గురించి చాలా చక్కగా మనకు వివరించారు ఆడా దేశం ద్వారా. థ్యాంక్ యూ ఫాదర్. ఇక్కడ ఉన్నీచర్స్ తరఫున పిల్లల తరఫున మీకు ధన్యవాదాలు తెలియజేసుకుంటున్నాను సార్. థ్యాంక్
యూ.
Don't take.